that we've melted now. We are adding 1 cup of, this was 1 cup of atta. We are going to add 1 more cup of atta to it. So these are 2 cups of atta. So we are roasting the wheat flour and we are making jaggery laddus. We are roasting it, we'll add little more ghee to it. Mix it well. So here we are mixing it well. Because it's not getting soaked. Alright, now see the consistency. We are continuously mixing it. So I think need for adding more ghee is required. So you are continuously stirring it. Do not leave the gas unattended and keep on adding ghee till it becomes a paste and easy to mix. It is little stiff, so keep on stirring it and it is, the gas is on simmer. Proper roasting is required. Form a paste of it. As you can see the consistency. Now the material has gone little softer, you can even feel it. Keep on stirring. Beautiful fragrance is coming. It has started to roast properly, burning like the wheat is proper cooked. And so it is properly roasted now. You can check. It has absorbed the ghee properly. Once you get the fragrance that it is getting burnt, roasted properly actually, take a tray and grease it with ghee. This is jaggery. We are beating it. This is grinded badam, almond. We are going to add it in the mixture. Chili powder, sieved properly for good flavor. And again we are going to add little bit of salt powder. See how beautifully the color is turning. And the wheat is leaving the ghee. And it is forming a paste. So now it is almost done. We have kept it aside to cool it a bit. Then we will add the jaggery in it. So do not add it on the gas. Separately we will add the jaggery and the badam mixture that we just made. So in this we are adding 1 whole cup of jaggery that we had grounded. Adding the badam powder. Mix it well, adding the jaggery that we have grounded tray. We are going to settle it down and then cut few pieces of it. Settle in tray, adding some maggots to it for extra garnishing. Again press it on the top. Now we are giving it slices so that when it cools down it can be taken out easily. So these are good patti. You can see the patti we are forming layers. So these are quite good snackers at home, made easily, really really gorgeous. So here the beautiful squares are cut. All ready, set. Now wheat patti, gur patti that we made. But now what I like is, this is very dry and I like ghee a lot. This is much better. What I did, I had preheated the ghee and then I added the 4 pieces of this and I want to make it like a pilli and with loads of ghee. If there is lots of ghee, then it is going to combine better. otherwise it's going to be dry like that. So depending on you, how much ghee you want to consume. If you want to have it dry, then you can have it like this as a patty, dry. But if you like more ghee, then you can make it like this. This is more gorgeous. Though both are tasty, but this is more on a ghee is nourished more in this. So this I'm going to make pindis out of it. And you better trust me when I tell you that the one with the more ghee is definitely worth it. This hot wheat and gur paste, I've made these laddu. These are quite nice as they are full of ghee. These are much nicer, and you can see the difference in the color also. This is with the ghee and these are dry. So these are more delicious, more nourishing. So better to add more ghee to it. So I hope that you make a wise choice, and these are beautiful laddus. Enjoy. So the choice is yours. I mean, this kadai here is very hot, so we have plenty more to go, but it's very hot, so I'm not making now. So this is the difference. You can check yourself. The one with the ghee is more desirable and yummy also. I mean, the other one is perfectly fine. Nothing has been changed. Only the quantity of ghee has made a lot of difference. You can check for yourself. Thank you so much for watching. Do try and have it, taste it. And do not forget to like and subscribe my channel. So this is two delicious gur wheat patty. This is very easy. And the art is to keep on cooking it on the simmer. So this is definitely today's dish and worth trying. Do try it. So these are the more ghee ones, you can check. Wow, this is really really yummy. Do try. And the art is to roast it in ghee in low flame. And once you're adding the jaggery, switch off the gas. In here, these are the ones that are dry ones. If you're not adding more of the ghee, this is what you'll get. If you're adding ample ghee, the picture is in front of you. These are actually breaking apart. This is going to retain its shape. So the choice is yours, ghee or no ghee. So I love this. These are really yummy. So I'm going to make more of these. So you can also try.